So my name is Vu, and I'm also a designer. And I also happen to be one of the founders and CEO of a company called Avocode. And beside the fact that we really like avocados and guacamole, we've also built a tool that bridges the gap between designers and developers. And with this tool, we've been able to help thousands of companies around the world, including companies like Samsung, Avast, or Intel, with turning their designs to code faster. Today, I wanted to share a little more about, tell you more about Design Handoff. And to do that, I decided to share a short story about how we, as our team, wanted to improve our own Design Handoff workflow, but ended up building a Design Handoff tool like Avocode. So me and my two other co-founders, Peter and Martin on this photo, we started about working together about 8 years ago. And we started as a small software agency. And obviously I was the designer and Martin and Peter were the developers. And every time I finished a design, all I did as a design handoff was basically send them the Photoshop file. Yeah, no red lines, no exported assets, no specs, just the file, you know? And each of the developer would have their own license for Photoshop, which they would use to open up these design files to get all of the assets they needed for coding themselves. And that's basically how our design handoff workflow looked like. I know, it's pretty bad and it sucked, but bear with me. So at the time, you know, skeuomorphic design was really popular. So designs, a lot of shadows, a lot of gradients, fancy stuff. And at the same time, CSS3 started to become very popular as well. We no longer had to use PNGs to recreate all of these buttons and UIs and inputs. And we could just use CSS code to recreate all of these designs. Peter and Martin weren't really good with Photoshop, so they actually forced me to manually write down all of the values I use in shadows, in gradients, all everything in layer styles manually, so they wouldn't have to do it. So, you know, I decided to Google if there was some maybe a better way to do this, because I always wanted to improve and continue improving my workflow. So I Googled, and there used to be a page called Forced. It used to be something like Dribbble nowadays, if you know. It was a community for designers and developers to share interesting projects they were working on. And on this page, on Forest, I found this post. You know, it was a Photoshop plugin that could automatically turn layer styles to CSS code. You know, exactly what I needed, really a problem solver. But as it turns out, guess what? It was just a design. Someone had a great idea to build this, but couldn't build it, so they just posted a screenshot like this. And so I asked Martin and Peter, hey guys, do you think we could maybe build something like this? And luckily they said yes. And that's how we basically built our first product for designers and developers. It was not Avocode yet. It was called CSS Hat. And it was a Photoshop plugin that could turn layer styles to CSS code automatically. And at the time, this was pretty revolutionary, you know, because there were no plugins into design tools, and the workflow still heavily depended on designers preparing everything manually. So with this small plugin, we're able to help people work a little more efficiently. A few months later, after we released it, Adobe came and added their own feature into Photoshop called Copy CSS, a feature that Sketch have nowadays by default. Even though they copied and added their own feature, I think building this first product was really one of the first attempts to bridge the gap between designers and developers. And I really believe that we were one of the companies that pioneered building plugins into design tools. We realized this was not the only problem that needed to be solved. So we actually went on to build 10 more Photoshop plugins under a brand called Source, to tackle other problems like image export or code export for iOS. But although all these tools were still helping designers and developers teams across the world work a little more efficiently, we're really just scratching the surface of a bigger problem. You know, design handoff was still a tedious process. You think about how a design file gets to a developer. You know, what if the developer received a design file, and he doesn't have the right design tool to open it, right? Should all developers buy design tools? Should they learn how to use them? Maybe all developers should use Mac because of Sketch, maybe? Well, of course not. Designers didn't have it easy at the time either. They were still forced to do everything manually, so specking all of the screens, redlining how elements were big and so on, and export each of the image assets manually. We really wanted to solve this bigger problem, but in order to build a right solution for this, we had a few requirements. We've came up a few requirements which we believe are right to approach all of this, to solve this problem in a bigger picture. So the first requirement that we came up with was to build one UI for developers to get specs and image assets. Because, you know, developers don't really need to access the design tool, and they should not care about what sort of like design tools you guys use to create the design, right? So this was the first requirement we've set out. The second requirement that we've set out was to allow developers to export any image asset from the design file without you guys preparing anything, basically. Even though there are tools out there right now that are solving this problem by forcing you to go by each layer and set them for export. It doesn't really save you much time if you think about it. You still have to go through all of those layers and set them ready for export. If you think about, for example, when you forget that to export that one icon from Sketch, the developer would go and bug you and eat you alive to open that Sketch again, find that layer, and export it all over again. So this was the second requirement. The third requirement that we've set out was to make Avocode fully cross-platform. And that doesn't mean only to make our app compatible with Mac, Windows, and Linux, but also allowing anyone to open the design file without using the design tool. So these were the requirements that we've set out. But however, as we started to build Avocode, we realized how hard this is technically going to be. You know, this was something that no one has ever built before. But after 12 months of development, we were able to successfully release the first version of Avocode. This is how it looked like. So this was back in 2015. And with this version, we've been able to only fulfill the first two requirements that we set out. That means we built one UI for the developer to access the design file, regardless of the design tool used by the designer. And we've allowed developers to get any assets they needed for coding themselves without designers preparing anything. The only requirement that we didn't meet was last one, to make Avocode fully cross-platform and independent on design tools. So it means only designers were able to import designs into Avocode. You actually had to have a Sketch or Photoshop plugin in order to actually sync those designs into our product. So you can tell that it was still dependent on design tools, and you still had to have a particular operating system to do so. And we're actually pretty much limited by the technology at the time, because the only way to access and extract data from the design file was using an API provided by the design tool, But we still wanted to build the product that we envisioned at the beginning. So unlike other design handoff tools that are still relying on the on third-party APIs until today, we've decided to build our own technology that would allow us to extract data from design formats, design files, without using any design tools. And in, it took us almost 2 years, I think, but I think it was worth it. And in spring of 2018, which was this year, we've introduced this technology with one of a major update of our product called Avocode 3. And thanks to this technology, we're able to basically break down all of the design formats and translate them into a universal standardized file format, which we call the Octopus file format. It's basically just a JSON object that is easily readable and accessible. And then we have our own design rendering we call Monroe rendering, which takes this Octopus file and renders this as exactly it was created in the original design tool. And the result is 99.9% rendering precision. So thanks to this technology, we've actually built the first truly cross-platform design handoff tool and met all of the requirements that I mentioned earlier. And this is how basically Avocode looks like and works today. You can start by creating a project and to make sure that your developers get the right type of code, right type of units for iOS, Android, or web. Once you have your project created, you can easily just import your designs into Avocode. We support all of the formats that are being used today, so Sketch, Photoshop, XD, Illustrator, and Figma. And if you don't have the design tool, they can just drag and drop and upload the design right inside of Avocode. That means anyone can really access and open these design files without using the original design tool. So developers don't really have to wait for you guys and beg you to like finally sync that design so I can work. They can actually do it on their own. And of course, if you're a designer, we still have an integration with Sketch to sync those designs with a Sketch plugin because, you know, it's very convenient to stay in your design tool and maybe sync it and then continue working. So we still have an integration. And I'm not saying that, you know, plugins are bad or good, but they're just for a different type of workflow. And we are all about supporting all types of workflow. And that's what we're doing, being as much agnostic as possible. If your designs live in a Dropbox, a company Dropbox, you can just import those designs with just a few clicks away. And that goes also for newer versions of that design. Once those designs are inside of Avocode, we'll automatically notify your team on Slack, if you're using Slack, or on email, so anyone can access those designs right away. And when those designs are inside of Avocode, everything the developer needs for coding is automatically generated. For example, getting CSS code is super easy. You can just click on different elements and copy all the entire snippet of code. You can even copy different kind of multiple layers. And you can not only copy not only CSS, but Android code, Swift code for iOS, or SCSS, you know, you name it. So this is code. You can also easily measure distances between different kind of elements. So for developers, this is super useful. And the cool thing is that developers can measure distances even between multiple layers, not just one. And of course, every asset, every layer inside of Avocode is ready for export. We also give you full access to all of the layers, so you can turn them on and turn them off. And you can even export multiple layers at once, separately, merge in all kinds of image formats like PNG, JPEG, or SVG. You can even export different variants of the same layer. For example, if you're exporting for iOS, you need 2x, 3x assets for in PNG, right? So you can do that all within Avocode. So developers, as you can see, developers have really easy access to all of the things they need for coding within Avocode. And all of that, of course, without you guys preparing anything, because we really believe that designers should spend more time on building and creating delightful user experiences rather than worrying about redlining, specking, or exporting images, right? And of course, we know that design is a continuous process, and basically it's never done, and you keep improving it. So we have that part of the workflow also covered inside of Avocode. So for example, if anyone in your team, for example, your project manager, wants to change this button, change the color of this button, they can easily just leave a comment on top of it. You automatically receive a notification telling you that this is the feedback. If you have the design file right on your computer, you can just open it up and make the changes. But if you don't, you can download the original sketch file from Avocode, implement all the changes, re-upload that into Avocode, and will automatically recognize this as a new version. So you can change all of the things. So in this case, making everything purple. When you're done, you can just hit sync again, and we'll notify everyone in the team that there's a new version. It's changed, and you can they can see how it's been changed. And the cool thing is that if the project manager really likes it, anyone in the team likes it, they can mark that comment as resolved. Now, I wanted to ask, how many of you use a prototyping feature inside of Sketch? You know about it? How many of you? No? Okay, a few of you, that's cool. Actually, so this feature basically allows you to create prototypes right within Sketch. And we've done sort of like a research, learning about how designers nowadays use prototyping, how they prototype. And we've learned that there are more and more designers using prototyping in Sketch rather than using tools like InVision or Marvel. And that's one of the reasons why we have that workflow covered inside of Avocode as well. So all you have to basically do is just sync the design into Avocode. If it had all of these flows, all of these connections between screen, we'll be able to recognize them. And anyone in the team can basically just hit the play button and preview that prototype. Yeah, so there's a button, and you can just hit play and see how the design actually works, how each screens are connected. Right, so that's basically how Avocode looks like today. Not only we've been able to fulfill all of the requirements we've set out at the beginning and build a product like this, but we've also built a technology along the way. And the technology that not only powers the core product that I've just shown you, Avocode, but we've also been able to build a first online design file format converter for Photoshop and Sketch, a tool that helps companies like Airbnb, Uber, or Inecom switch from Photoshop to Sketch faster. All you have to do is just upload the design, a Photoshop design, even an old one, else spit out a valid Sketch file that you can just use as it is. We really believe that solving bigger problems heavily depends on a great technology. We started with solving small problems for our own, me wanting to improve my own workflow, but we've ended up building a solution that's not only helpful to us, but to the entire world through our technology. So if you're building and working on something and want to make it great, or you just want to improve your design and your workflow, start with the little things. So that's it from me. Thanks.